Northern St. Mary's County, up around your area.
Yeah. Yep. Welcome you to St. Clement's Island and Blessing the Fleet.
That's right.
Thank you.
Uh-huh. Nice to see you. How you doing?
Beautiful day.
Beautiful day. You getting down here a lot lately.
Yes, sir.
You must be running for governor.
Don't take the swings at any time to enter.
We're gathered here today to commemorate our beginnings. On this very hallowed ground in 1634, the state of Maryland was born. The Maryland pilgrims cut down a tree right here and made it into a great cross that we're symbolically celebrating today. Then beside that great cross, Father Andrew White said Mass, and Maryland's first pilgrims, Catholics and Protestants together, knelt down and thanked God for their safe passage across the dangerous waters from Europe. And it was written in Father White's account of the time that the pilgrims prayed with emotion and with devotion took solemn possession of this new country. This simple act of human faith in God was symbolic indeed of the It was symbolic of the greatness and the prosperity to come from the planting of a fertile seed that today is religious tolerance. We take it for granted today, freedom of faith and freedom of conscience. It's hard to imagine a time when these principles were considered totally impractical and even blasphemous. Perhaps the closest we come to an understanding of religious intolerance is what we now view on television in the comfort of our homes. The images come from faraway places, and the people seem alien to us and the way we live. Today, coming here to this place on the bay, on the Potomac River, and remembering the Ark and the Dove, and the wisdom of George Calvert, the first Lord Baltimore, who, although Roman Catholic, conceived that Maryland would be a haven for all of those believing in the Trinity, is a reminder to us all that our differences in faith are reasons for celebration and not reasons for alienation. This is not the appropriate time or place to recall those instances throughout our history when religious intolerance prevailed. And this is not the day to dwell upon the barbarities inflicted upon and suffered by all religious groups. But let us at least touch on it to the degree that it helped us see this land through the eyes of the first Marylanders when they first arrived here. Their mother England has been cursed for centuries by its own legacy of religious intolerance. But imagine for a moment the complex emotions felt by those early Marylanders. For sure, they were struck by the beauty of this place. Father White described in this way in his journal, "This bay is the most delightful water I ever saw between two sweet lands, with a channel 8 fathoms deep and 10 leagues broad, full of fish. This is the sweetest and greatest river I have seen, so that the Thames is but a little finger of it." I am sure all of us who love the Chesapeake Bay would agree with Father White's description. But most importantly, once on these shores, the first Marylanders prayed together. On these Maryland shores, freedom of conscience was at once and consistently put into practice. And although the Calverts were Catholic, they were not trying to establish Catholicism in Maryland. They wisely foresaw that to succeed as Catholics, the colony would have to be established for both Catholics and Protestants. They recognized that for freedom, religious freedom to flourish, every effort had to be made to minimize religious differences. In order for the new world to prosper and to grow, it would take the best from everyone, including laborers and artisans who were mainly Protestant. Their approach brought years of peace to the colony. Some 35 years later, in 1649, the Maryland General Assembly would enact what became known as Maryland's Act of Toleration, a model for progressive thought. No person or persons whatsoever within this province or the islands, ports, harbors, creeks, and havens thereunto, belonging, professing to belong, to believe in Jesus Christ, shall from henceforth be any way troubled, molested, or discountenanced for or in respect of his or her religion, nor in the free exercise thereof within this province. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, we still have religious bigots among us, but their influence will always be minimal. And in its day, this legislation did not include the protection of our Jewish brothers and sisters. That would come later. Still, the law was forward-thinking in its time. These are words for us not only to cherish as an important chapter of history, they are words with a meaning that speak to us today. In closing, as we stand here on this hallowed ground today, let us rededicate and recommit ourselves to teaching our young people that no civilization can survive without faith, without conscience, because we humans are both physical and spiritual beings. We must have freedom of faith, freedom of conscience. There is ultimately no such thing as freedom from faith or freedom from conscience. Realizing and living that truth in America today would solve an awful lot of our problems.
Is it true their head will rotate all the way around?
No, that's not true. They can turn their head. I don't know if they'll actually be able to follow me. Probably just turn around.
He's gonna turn around. So sees their turn around and swivel his head.
Yeah. The screech owl might do it. But what they do is they can turn their head basically all the way around to the back, but they can't actually turn it all the way around a complete circle.
Yeah.
They did that their head.
Oh, there he goes. So, yeah, he's doing pretty good there. Yeah. That's so they can keep an eye on something sneaking up on them.
Looks like a cat from that angle there.
Yeah, I know. The eyes look like cat eyes. Museum. Right.
Clement's Island Museum. They landed on the island in 1634 and looked for better harvest, better land, religious toleration.
Right.
Okay, and they landed on the island. They figured it was safer from the Indians on both the Virginia side and the Maryland side, so they landed on the island so they got to know the area better. From there, they went down to St. Mary's City. And then that's where they made their tent and home and where they landed at.
The original settlers back in
1634.
And the first mass was sent there.
First Catholic mass.
And they came from where to here?
From England. They came from England to here.
From England?
Yeah, all the way. And when they landed, the ladies got off and washed the clothes, and the boat flipped over, and their drawers and everything went everywhere in the water. And that's a true story.
Handed down several centuries.
Several centuries, yep. Father Andrew White said his first mass.
And this mural behind you is...
It's pretty much the same sketch of them landing, and Father Andrew White here saying his mass. The Ark was the bigger ship.
Oh, you're talking about the Ark and the Dove, right?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
The Ark is the bigger ship, and that's what carried the passengers. The Dove was the one that carried the supplies. The Dove stayed down here in St. Mary's, and then the Ark went back to England to fight in the war for the king.
Thank you. Yeah, it's really nice. First time I've ever been here. It's really a nice place.
What does she look like?
Yeah, I mean, the interpretation of what happened back in 1634 is pretty well documented here, and I think it's a great tour for kids and the whole family. So those people who would like to come over and visit, I think that it's well worth the trip.
It's not that far from Calvert County either.
No, you're about 25, 30 minutes away from a good Thomas Johnson Memorial Bridge, which connects these inner counties now. And we're all joint neighbors in an adventure in trying to learn history.
Right. Yeah. Well, that's great. Good talking with you.
Good talking to you, Doug.